friends, welcome to RH Chemistry. Today's topic is aldehyde, ketones and carboxylic acids, very important chapter for KCET 2020 final punch series. So here I have solved 2014 to 2018 questions. 2019 already I have solved. I have given the link in the description box that you can see. Now we will discuss about quick synopsis. So in that case, first I will tell you preparation of aliphatic aldehydes. Preparation of aliphatic aldehydes. So in case of the aliphatic aldehydes, remember, first we will see RCHO general preparation I have explained. First one, RCS2OH undergo oxidation. RCS2OH primary alcohol undergo oxidation to form RCHO. RMGX give rise to RCOOR. How this Grignard reagent converts into this aldehyde, I have made a separate video on Grignard reagent in detail that you can refer. The link is given in the description box. RMGX HCOOR formic ester give rise to RCHO, and Rosenmund's reduction, we know that acid halides. So RCOCl plus H2 give rise to PDA-BASO4 give rise to this. So this is very important reaction, which is not in the textbook, NCRT, but it was asked once in CET, remember. So here, calcium salts of fatty acids. So calcium salts of fatty acids, remember. So calcium salts of fatty acids reacts with calcium formate, give rise to, on dry distillation we call it as, calcium salts of fatty acids, calcium formate, you are going to give rise to RCHO. Here, calcium carbonate CaCO3 is removed, remember, minus CaCO3 is removed, so you are going to get RCHO, that is aldehyde preparation. Then we will see aromatic aldehyde. So in case of the aromatic aldehyde, see, first one, CCH5COCl, benzoyl chloride, on reduction, Rosenmund's reduction, once again forming RCHO. Then CCH5CS2H, benzoyl alcohol, on oxidation give rise to CHO. Then Guterman-Koch reaction, remember, C6H is benzene react with CO and HCl in presence of AlCl3 forming the benzaldehyde. Stefan's reduction, you can follow this Stefan reduction here also, remember, RCN you can consider, CCH5CN, HCl, SNCl2, so on followed by hydrolysis you are going to get, so CHO, benzaldehyde. Then Etard's reaction, important Etard's reaction, remember. So chromyl chloride, once it was asked in CET, chromyl chloride in presence of CS2 on followed by hydrolysis give rise to CHO. And here also remember, calcium benzoate and calcium formate, here also CaCO3 is removed. Calcium salts of fatty acids reacts with calcium formate. If it is benzene, if you want CH5CHO, you have to take CH6H5O. If you want CS3R, then R you have to take it here. So very simple, R you have to take. So on heating, dry distillation, you are going to get benzaldehyde. So these are the preparation of this benzaldehyde. So after that, we'll move to the some important points, like aldehydes are more reactive than ketones. Remember that aldehydes are more reactive than ketones, because in case of the ketones, steric hindrance will be there and nucleophilicity will be more for aldehydes, remember. So now aldehydes are more reactive than ketone, right? So for example, I have given one. So benzaldehyde and acetophenone, if you consider, benzaldehyde is more reactive than acetophenone. Similarly, acetaldehyde and the acetone, if I consider, acetaldehyde is more reactive than acetone. Very, very important point. Then which I am going to discuss, five star concept. Remember, so halo form reaction or iodo form reaction. So the reagent for this is halogen in presence of NaOH, or they can give it as NaOX. This is also correct. They may give it as NaOX, NaOH plus X2 also they can give. X is ClBr or I. Now what happens is RCOCH3 ketone, for example, reacts with this under halo form reaction forming CHX3. So halo form we call it as, if it is CHI3 we call it as iodo form, remember, iodo form. The very famous is iodo form reaction, fine. RCONA. So what you have to remember here, very, very, very important, note down this point. This is shown by only CS3CO group should be there in the molecule, or CS3CHOH group should be there in the molecule. CS3C double bond O group, CS3CHOH group should be there in the molecule. Some examples we will see. See, I have given some molecules, right? So now you have to select whether it is possible or not. Now you will see that. So first one you can see CH3CHO. CH3CH2 means CH3CO group is there. Hence this can show the haloform reaction. C6H5CHO. So here CH3CO group is not there. Hence it cannot show. Here CH3CO group is not there. CH3CH2CO is there. This cannot show. CH3CHOH group should be there. But here CH3CH2CH2OH group is there. This also cannot show. HCHO, there is no CH3 group, cannot show. But this can show because this is followed. CH3CHOH condition is required. So CH3CHOH is there. Followed. CH3COCH3, COCH3 is there, right? So it can follow. CH3COCH3, so it can show. Remember, in case of the aldehyde, only acetaldehyde can show haloform reaction. So this is an important reaction which can differentiate benzaldehyde with acetaldehyde. Benzaldehyde with acetone. Acetaldehyde also. Benzaldehyde with, remember, this acetophenone. So this differentiation test you can do by using haloform reaction. So this is very, very important reaction. Note down this point. Then we'll move to nucleophilic addition reaction, then condensation reaction. So in case of the nucleophilic addition reaction, you can see, so C double bond, general reaction I have written, HCN, you are going to get cyanohydrine. HCN, cyanohydrine. Sodium bisulfite, adduct you are going to get. RMGX forming ROH, that is, if it is aldehyde, secondary alcohol, ketone, tertiary alcohol. Remember, if it is HCHO, primary alcohol. So how it conversion take place, I have given in the Grignard reagent part, the another video, the link is given in the description box. Right? Now, if it is C2H5OH, so hemiacetal or ketal is going to form C2H5OH. So in presence of HCl gas, OH and OC2H5 is going to form hemiacetal or hemiketal. If it is RCR, both are R group, ketal. If one is R group, hemiacetal. Then it reacts with another mole of CH3COH, another mole of CH3COH forming acetal or ketal. Acetal or ketal is going to form, remember. So another mole of C2H5. So another mole it is going to give rise to acetal or ketal. Right? So this is about the C nucleophilic addition reaction. Then we will see condensation reaction. So in case of the condensation reaction, remember, condensation reaction, so like this. Here you can see C double bond. Once again, general reaction I have taken. So C double bond, hydroxylamine give rise to oxime. NS2H, hydroxylamine give rise to oxime. Hydrazine, NS2 give rise to hydrazone. So phenylhydrazine, C6H5NH2 give rise to phenylhydrazone. So semicarbazide give rise to semicarbazone. And this is the one test which is used to detect the carbonyl group in the compound. So if the organic compound is given, carbonyl group is there or not, how to identify? By using 2,4-DNP test. 2,4-DNP test. 2,4-dinitrophenylhydrazine. When it reacts with C double bond, you are going to get orange or yellow color precipitate. If this precipitate is formed, which means there is a carbonyl group in the compound. This is about condensation reactions and nucleophilic addition reactions. So after this, let us move to the special reactions. So special reactions of these, the aldehyde, ketones and carboxylic acids. So that special reactions, we will see that. So first one, undergo oxidation. Remember, under special reaction, when it undergo oxidation, so C double bond give rise to RCOOH. We know that RCOOH is going to form. Fine. Then, RC double bond H. See, RC double bond H, that is aldehyde I have considered. When it reacts with Tollens reagent. Tollens reagent is AgNS3, twice ammonical silver nitrate is called as Tollens reagent. So, when it reacts with Tollens reagent, remember, so you are going to get the silver mirror. So this is also called a silver mirror test. Remember, silver mirror test. Correct? So RCO minus carboxylate ion and silver is going to form. Silver mirror you are going to get. So ketone does not show this particular test. Then, Fehling solution test. So Fehling's test. Remember, Fehling solution is nothing but Fehling's A and Fehling's B. Fehling's A is CuSO4. Fehling's B is NaOH and Rochelle salt. Rochelle's salt is nothing but sodium potassium tartarate. Fehling solution when it reacts with RCHO, you are going to get similarly RCO minus Cu2O. Cu2O is known as red precipitate. It is red precipitate. That is an identification test, remember. Very important distinguishing test for aldehyde and ketone. These two are distinguishing test for aldehyde and ketone. One important note what you have to remember is
aromatic aldehydes. Aromatic aldehyde, if it is, for example, C6H5CHO, that is benzaldehyde, do not reduce valence solution. Do not reduce valence solution. As the reason for that is, it is having sodium hydroxide, right? Sodium hydroxide, concentrated sodium hydroxide, it undergo Cannizzaro's reaction. Very important point. Aromatic aldehyde do not reduce valence solution, so it undergo Cannizzaro's reaction. Remember that. Then Clemmensen's reduction. Clemmensen's reduction, in case of the Clemmensen's reduction, remember, in this case, so Clemmensen's, Ulf Kirchner, everything I have considered in one reaction. So here you can see, carbonyl group converted into H2, hydrocarbon. Carbonyl group to hydrocarbon, three reagents are useful. One is zinc amalgam HCl. Zinc amalgam HCl, Clemmensen's reduction. NH2NH2KOH. NH2NH2KOH, Ulf Kirchner reduction. Remember Ulf Kirchner reduction. Hydrazine in presence of KOH and ethylene glycol also. HI and red phosphorus. HI and red phosphorus, you are going to get once again CS2, that is alkane. So this is about the reduction of this carbonyl group. Then we'll move to important aldol condensation. Aldol condensation, see. Aldol condensation is, first of all, it is shown by only those aldehydes which is having the alpha hydrogen. Remember, alpha hydrogen. So alpha hydrogen is more acidic in nature, remember. So for example, I have considered acetaldehyde, CH3CHO, undergo dilute alkali. Here the reagent is dilute alkali. Dilute alkali means NaOH or Na2CO3 or BaOH twice. Remember, barium hydroxide, sodium carbonate, NaOH. Yavudidru kuda, you are going to get the aldol condensation reaction. First you are going to get, so this is nothing but, so aldol, we will call it as this as aldol. Remember, aldol, then undergo condensation to form alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde, that is, here in this case it is the you are going to get protonaldehyde anta karithivi idakke. So CH3CH double bond CH, you are going to get cross aldol condensation andre eno. So cross aldol condensation means one aldehyde with alpha hydrogen, one aldehyde without alpha hydrogen, with alpha hydrogen, without alpha hydrogen, cross aldol condensation you are going to get. So for example, CH2CHO, CH5CHO give rise to CH5CH double bond CH, this is known as cinnamaldehyde. Remember, cinnamaldehyde, CCH4CH double bond CH, CHO. This is about alpha hydrogen, aldol condensation. Ishtu nenpittukolri, simple agi alpha hydrogen idre aldol condensation torustade. This is about special reaction, aldol condensation. So next we'll discuss about Cannizzaro's reaction. Important Cannizzaro's reaction. So there are so many reactions. There are so many reactions for NEET and JEE, very, very important. But for CET, that many reactions are not needed. Hence, I have not considered. Actually, for CET, Perkins reaction is there, benzoyl condensation is there, Claisen-Schimmel reaction is there. So pinacol-pinacolone rearrangement is there. For all those are there. But CET point of view, my concentration on CET here, so I have not considered those reactions. Cannizzaro's reaction, without alpha hydrogen it can undergo. Cannizzaro's reaction, without alpha hydrogen, remember that very important point. Then you can see, here I have considered HCHO, alpha hydrogen is not there. Alpha hydrogen means, remember, the hydrogen beside C double bond O group. So, C double bond O, there is no carbon attached. So, alpha carbon only it is not there, so there is no alpha hydrogen. So, this can undergo concentrated alkali, NaOH or KOH, concentrated alkali. In any passage type of reaction, if you consider aldehyde react with concentrated alkali to form anta idre, so it is always Cannizzaro's reaction. Remember that point. Cannizzaro's reaction, concentrated alkali, aldehyde, aldol condensation, that is dilute alkali. Then you are going to get methyl alcohol and HCOONa. So alcohol you are going to get and sodium salt of alcohol you are going to get. Right? So now you can see this benzaldehyde when it undergo, Cannizzaro's reaction, you are going to get CS2HCOONa. So this is about Cannizzaro's reaction. Then we'll move to carboxylic acid. Very important carboxylic acid. So carboxylic acid, first we'll see preparation of aliphatic carboxylic acid. Aliphatic carboxylic acid. See, this is aliphatic carboxylic acid. So the preparation. So first one, alcohol. RCS2OH give rise to RCOH. RCS2OH give rise to RCOH when it is under oxidation. RCOCS3X2NaOH, just now we have seen haloform reaction, RCOO minus I have written, so RCOOH you are going to get. RCN, cyanide, undergo hydrolysis, carboxylic acid. RMGX react with carbon dioxide, this also I have explained in that video. RMGX react with carbon dioxide, RCOOH. RCOR, esters, amides, all these when it undergo hydrolysis. So cyanides, esters, amides, all these undergo hydrolysis to form carboxylic acid. Finally, Koch reaction we call it as. Guterman is not there. Guterman, Koch is our aldehyde. So it is only Koch reaction. So alkene react with carbon monoxide and H2O in presence of H3PO4, you are going to get RCOOH. Koch reaction, remember, this is not there for CET, but I have taken. Then we will see here the carboxylic acid in that aromatic carboxylic acid, that is benzoic acid, very famous benzoic acid, correct? So now you can see benzoic acid, so phenyl magnesium bromide, carbon dioxide jothe react adre en bartade carbon, this benzoic acid. Then so this alkyl benzene on oxidation with KMnO4, benzoic acid. Cyanobenzene hydrolysis, COOH, cyanobenzene. And CCH5CONS2 benzamide, so on hydrolysis give rise to carboxylic acid. One thing you remember, carboxylic acid in which COOH group is electron withdrawing group, hence this is always meta directing, remember that, right? So acidic nature of carboxylic acid, eastern np told very very simple one line, electron donating group remember decreases the acidic nature, electron withdrawing group increases the acidic nature. Everything is over if it is electron withdrawing group increases the acidic nature, electron donating group decreases the acidic nature. Fixed question. So very very important, acidic nature, remember that. Then finally we will move to reactions of carboxylic acids. So reactions of carboxylic acid, see some important reactions I have considered in this particular case. Very very important reactions of carboxylic acids. See, very nice, colorful. Chemistry is always colorful, remember. So carboxylic acid, right? RCOOH, first remember it is acidic in nature, correct? Acidic in nature, react with potassium or sodium or calcium or zinc, RCOONa and hydrogen gas is released. If it react with sodium hydroxide, RCOONa plus H2O is formed. If it is ammonia, first we will form ammonium salt, then on heating give rise to amide, RCONS2. PCl5, PCl3, SOCl2. So this will replace OH group in this case. So RCOCl, acid halide, is going to form. Then P2O5 or concentrated H2SO4. Remember, this reaction is called as dehydration. Dehydration reaction, you are going to get as anhydride of acid. Anhydride you are going to obtain. RMgBr, RH, remember me, RH. RMgBr, this is acidic hydrogen, so R and H, RH is going to form. Once again, you have to remember me, so that is decarboxylation reaction. Soda lime we call it as, correct? So decarboxylation, NaOH and CaO, you are going to get RH plus Na2CO3. Then LiAlH4, that is lithium aluminum hydride, RCS2H, you are going to form. Then red phosphorus and HI, very important reagent, you are going to get RCH3. So these are the important reaction. Then lastly, two reaction. One is HVZ reaction. HV, Hall, Wellhard, Jelonsky reaction. That is alpha hydrogen. Alpha hydrogen get replaced by halogen. So RCS2COH, alpha hydrogen is this one. RCS2H react with Cl2 in presence of red phosphorus. You are going to get RCHClCOH. And further, if the excess amount of Cl2 is there, you are going to get both alpha hydrogen get substituted to form RCl2COH. Finally, esterification reaction. Remember, carboxylic acid react with alcohol to form esters and water is removed. And H2SO4, it is acting as a catalyst which will remove the water molecule and it will make that reaction moving towards forward direction. It will make equilibrium towards forward reaction. This is about quick synopsis part of, remember, the aldehydes, ketones and carboxylic acids chapter. So let us now, we'll discuss about the previous year questions. Yes, first one, I think it is visible, right? First one, the appropriate reagent for the following transformation is transformation yen agide correct agi observe madri. So C double bond convert into CH2, C double bond convert into CS2. So one though Clemmensen's reduction, illa andre Wolff-Kishner reduction. Hence these two not at all the answer. Correct? Out of these two, one answer. Why not Clemmensen's? Why only Wolff-Kishner? I will tell you. See, here you can see HCl is there, correct? Acid. Here what is there? OH group is there. So that remember this OH replaced by Cl. OH also replaced by Cl if you use Clemmensen's reagent. But here OH is there, here also OH is there, no difference in the product. So OH group will be never be touched at all. OH group disturb agodilla. Aduke remember suitable reagent is B. A is also wrong. Suitable reagent is B. Remember that. Then second reaction. In the following reaction, reaction is given. Correct? So in the following reaction, the compound Z is, they are asking compound Z. Very important reaction. Yavudidu hesaru nenpadkolri. Itars reaction. Itars reaction hege nenpagtada sir, nodid takshana hege gotagtada? See, what is this? Who is he? So chromyl chloride. Correct? So chromyl chloride namatra barodu onde ondu kade, that is Itars reaction. Hence you are going to get Itars reaction. Definitely this is a intermediate is going to form. Finally the product on hydrolysis give rise to Z. Z is nothing but benzaldehyde. Z is nothing but benzaldehyde. Hence the second question, remember answer is B. Answer is B. This is about the 2018 asked question. This is also 2018. This is also 2018 asked question. Remember that. Now you will see next 2017, 17 and 18 I have taken. Fine. In the following sequence of reaction, CH3BrKCN give rise to A, give rise to B on hydrolysis, give rise to C on once again reduction. Cyanide, KCN, hydrolysis and LaAlH4. Then how to solve this? Yes, write the reaction. CH3Br, CH3Br and CN is replaced. Hence remember A you are going to get CH3CN. Very simple. Correct? CH3CN when it undergo hydrolysis, B you are going to get, the meaning is what? CH3CH2OH. So hydrolysis, cyanide on undergo hydrolysis, directly you will get COOH, you are going to get carboxylic acid. Then undergo reduction, remember, you are going to get C2H5OH. So C2H5OH, that is B, ethyl alcohol is the answer. Very simple reaction, correct? Right. So fourth one, 2017 asked question, this is also 2017 asked question, which is the answer if you ask me? Which is the answer if you ask me? I will tell you the answer. Here, this is the 1 year where the students have got grace marks. Grace marks, remember? The grace marks because there is no answer. There is no answer for this question. Why it is no answer? So see that. So Cannizzaro's reaction is an example of auto oxidation. Correct? Auto oxidation. Then you see, it is a typical reaction of aliphatic aldehyde. Wrong. Remember, HCHO it can show. Similarly, C6H5CHO also can show. Which means this is also wrong. This is also wrong. Typical aromatic aldehyde. That is also wrong. Right? It is a reaction answered by all aldehyde. Wrong. Wrong. It is a reaction answered by only alpha hydrogen. Aldehyde and alpha hydrogen. Actually Cannizzaro's reaction without alpha hydrogen, correct? Since this is also wrong, hence I told grace marks I will give. I have given grace marks to you. Fine, enjoy. So, right. Fifth question. Which of the following compound undergo haloform reaction? 2018 asked question. I told you haloform helbekadre helide. Very, very important concept. Minimum 2 to 3 questions I will show you out of 2014 to 2018 paper. Which of the following compound undergo haloform reaction? See, haloform reaction to show CH3CO group should be there or CH3CHOH group should be there. Hoda? So you can see this is not the answer. This is not at all. This is not at all. Answer is what? A. CH3CO, CH3. Very important question. Fifth question. 2018 asked question. Right. Now we will see sixth question. Now predict the product C in the following series. 2016 asked question it is. Predict the product C in the following series. Fine. CH3COOH. I told CH3COOH give rise to A. A should be what? So CH3COCl. Correct? CH3COCl. Then CH3COCl with CCH6. What is the reaction called as? Friedel-Crafts. Acylation reaction. Correct? So acylation reaction. So here the electrophile which is formed is CH3CO plus. This will attack on the benzene. You are going to get, remember, so B as C6H5O CO CH3 acetophenone. CH5CO CS3 acetophenone is going to form. Then remember, acetophenone, correct? Acetophenone CS3 C double bond CS3. When it is CS3MGBR, how to write the product? I told CS3MGBR C double bond is there, make it as OH. Make it as OH immediately. So then this is CS3, you attach one side CS3. Then what is left? Another CS3 at this side. Correct? This should be the answer. Correct? So this should be the answer, means what is the answer? So fine. So D is the answer, 6-1. Correct? So D. Then 7. Lower members of aliphatic carboxylic acids are soluble in water. This is due to, very simple question it is. So whenever there is a solubility question, one thing you have to say, there should be hydrogen bonding. There should be hydrogen bonding. Hydrogen bonds with the water. That should be the answer. This London force water non-electrolyte is not at all the answer. So the answer for 7th question is, aliphatic carboxylic acids are soluble in water because of hydrogen bonds in water. Then 8th one, reduction of ketone cannot be carried out. 2017 asked question. It is also 2017. Remember, reduction of ketones cannot be carried out with which of the following reagent? Reduction of ketone. So in this particular case, remember, reduction of ketone anta helta idare, how it is take place? So if it is reduction, ketone undergo reduction, remember, you are going to get CS2, correct? So to make it that, remember, we need zinc amalgam in constant NaOH possible, hydrazine with KOH is also possible, because these two are Clemmensen's reduction and Wolff-Kishner reduction, no doubt. And this is very good reducing agent, it is also possible. But remember, palladium in barium sulfate is Rosenmund's reduction. Rosenmund's reduction means you will never get this. So this should be hydrogen in nickel or platinum or palladium, you can say, if this reaction take place. But palladium in presence of barium sulfate and quinoline, the reaction never take place. So the answer for this particular question is A. That is 8th question. Then we will see question number 9. Acetic acid is treated with calcium hydroxide and the product so obtained is subjected to dry distillation. The final product formed is acetic acid treated with calcium hydroxide. So what is going to get? Acetic acid when it treated with calcium hydroxide, what are we going to get? See, CH3COOH plus calcium hydroxide, you are going to get. So this is acidic hydrogen, correct? So acidic hydrogen. Hence, remember, H2O is removed, minus H2O, you are going to get CH3COO twice Ca, calcium acetate is going to form. Calcium acetate, when it's subjected to this dry distillation, calcium acetate, when it's subjected to dry distillation, which is the product you are going to get? So remember, CH3, they are not given formic, they are given acetic only, right? So you are going to get the compound as CH3COCH3. Remember, acetone you are going to get plus CaCO3 is removed. Hence the answer for this question is D. Propanone is the answer. Propanone is the answer. 2015 asked question. Distinguishing test between methanoic acid and ethanoic acid. Very simple, very important. Methanoic acid and ethanoic acid, see. Tollens reagent, sodium bicarbonate, litmus test, esterification test. One thing you remember, both are acid. Correct? Both are acid. Hence, sodium bicarbonate, carbon dioxide is evolved. Sodium bicarbonate, which will give out carbon dioxide when acid is added. So, both will give rise to carbon dioxide. Both. Hence, this is not the answer. Litmus test. It is a test which is used to indicate this acidic nature. Both are acid. You are going to get the litmus test same. So this is not the answer. Esterification test. Both acid can undergo esterification. There is no test. But Tollens reagent is the test. Now you can ask me, sir, it is acid. In acid, Tollens reagent, how it comes? Remember, Tollens reagent is shown by aldehyde. Correct? Which is shown by aldehyde. Then you can say methanoic acid. That's formic acid. Formic acid, how you write? HC double bond OH. Correct? Now in this you can see there is a aldehydic group also, HC double bond O group also. This is the only acid which can show Tollens test. Remember, this is the only acid which can show Tollens test. Hence the answer for this is A, because aldehyde group is present. You can see in one side aldehyde, another side carboxylic acid. So hence it can show, remember, this Tollens test. Now, 11th question, 2016 asked question. Question is very big, but the answer is very simple. See, I told benzene carbaldehyde. What is the meaning of benzene carbaldehyde? So, benzene carbaldehyde is nothing but C6H5CHO. No doubt in it. With concentrated NaOH, see, concentrated NaOH, which means what you have to remember, I told, whenever there is a this aldehyde react with concentrated alkali, the reaction is Cannizzaro, Mario Hage illa, Cannizzaro reaction, you have to remember. Now answer is ready. Cannizzaro's reaction, aldehyde when it undergo Cannizzaro's reaction, that is benzaldehyde, you are going to get sodium benzoate and phenyl methanol. B answer, phenyl methanol is new for us. So if it is given like this, benzyl alcohol, you can say easily CS2H. Correct? What is the IUPAC name of this? This is phenyl group and this is the methanol. Methanol, correct? Phenyl methanol. So phenyl methanol and sodium benzoate. Remember what they have told, A can be used as food preservative. Sodium benzoate is an example for food preservative. Right? So B is aromatic hydroxy compound. Aromatic hydroxy compound where OH group attached to sp3 hybridized carbon. OH group attached to sp3 hybridized carbon. Hence, the answer for this question is B. But within a second, you can tell very easily the answer. That is benzaldehyde undergo concentrated NaOH reaction, which means Cannizzaro's reaction. No doubt in it. So very, very important. 11th question. Then you will see 12th question. So now, in this case, acetophenone cannot be prepared easily by... So in this case, acetophenone cannot be prepared easily. It's starting from. So what they have given? Acetophenone cannot be prepared easily. So now you can see. A. Whether acetone is prepared easily? Yes, very important. Very simple also. Correct? Very simple. So here PCC or PDC. If you take this and add PCC or PDC, you are going to get C6H5COCH3. Right? Now. This one we know that Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction, when it reacts with CS3COCl, you are going to get same. And this one, idukond reaction barithim nodri, C6H5C triple bond CH, when it reacts with mercuric salt, so Hg2 plus in presence of H plus. Remember, this is the reaction where first you have to get enol form, then it will convert into keto form. In hydrocarbon chapter, I will discuss in detail. So you are going to get here. So this is Hg2 plus and H plus. Enol form you are going to get. Then keto form C6H5C double bond CH3 you are going to get. Hence, this also can be possible. But one thing you remember, toluene. This is toluene. Toluene is the one from which the preparation of acetophenone is not easy. Very, very difficult. Hence, the answer is B. The formation of cyanohydrin from a ketone is an example of. So, very simple. 13th nucleophilic addition reaction. A. Correct? So, A. Then, iodoform can be prepared from all except. Once again, iodoform can be prepared from all except. I told. Second time this question. Iodoform reaction. Now you can see butan-2-1. Butan-2-1 means what? C double bond of CH3. This can show. Correct? Acetophenone. We know that acetophenone CCH5COCH3. COCH3 group is there, which can show. Propan-2-ol. Propan-2-ol you can say CH3COHCH3. CH3COH group is there. It can show. But propan-1-ol CH3CH2OH. Here CH3CH2CH2OH propan-1-ol. Yes, propan-2-ol, right? Propan-1-ol CH3CH2OH. Here CH3CHOH group is not there, hence it should be the answer. So this should be the answer. Propan-1-ol, remember, which cannot undergo iodoform test. So iodoform test agodilla, iodoform formation agodilla. So remember that. Then we'll see 15th question. Acid strength of active methylene group in, remember, acidic strength. Now, always remember in this case, one thing I will tell you. Whenever CH2 group is present between C double bond O. Whenever methylene group is present between two carbonyl group. It is very, very acidic in nature. It is very, very acidic in nature. Because here whatever keto enol tautomerism is there. So this can possible very easily. So hence remember, in this particular case, 2 should be more. 2 should be more, only one option left. So answer should be C. Then you can see one. So one side keto group is, another side ester group is there. Ester group, remember ester group is least acidic. So this is more acidic, CH2CO is there. One side, both sides CO, more acidic. Second, one side CO, one side ester, that is acidic. Both side ester, COO, CO, both side ester, weakly acidic. Hence remember, answer for this question is C. Then 16th, X undergo osmolysis, give rise to Y plus Z. Y can be obtained by Itard's reaction. Y can be obtained by Itard's reaction. So in all these case, benzene ring is there. Oh, the benzene ring is there. Then CH double bond is there. Itard's reaction means definitely it should be CHO. No doubt in it. Y can be obtained by CH. Itard's reaction means Y should be CHO. Then Z undergo disproportionation reaction with concentrated alkali. So disproportionation reaction, remember it is the nature of Cannizzaro's reaction. Cannizzaro's reaction, it is disproportionation reaction. With concentrated alkali is there means what? Cannizzaro's reaction. Now, Y can also undergo this concentrated alkali, but they have not told that Y can undergo. Y also can undergo. But Y already they have told the hint. For Y they have given the hint. But Z hint is with concentrated alkali, remember, with concentrated alkali, it can undergo disproportion reaction. Hence, now the answer is. Now, ozonolysis, remember, ozonolysis product, how to write, I will tell you very simple. And in hydrocarbon, I will discuss in detail. So, if it is double bond, I will tell you very easily. You cut this bond, you add one double bond, O, one O here. And the product, in birth of the? So, here, H, the CHO plus HCHO. Here also, you put one oxygen here, one oxygen here. So, CHO plus CH3CHO, CH3CHO. Here also you put one oxygen here, very simple. Ozonolysis is very important reaction, remember. CHO plus CH3COCH3. Correct? But here you are going to get, because triple bond is there, triple bond, directly you cannot add. So triple bond is there, hence you are going to get the compound. How you are going to get this compound when triple bond andre alkynes undergo osmolysis? These things I am going to discuss in case of hydrocarbon chapter. So here I will not touch that concept. So but remember this product COOH plus HCOOH you are going to obtain. Now tell me Itard's reaction, right? All these three. But Z can undergo disproportionate reaction under Cannizzaro's reaction. Z can undergo Cannizzaro's. Which one? This cannot. Because alpha hydrogen is there, this cannot, alpha hydrogen is there, this can undergo. So the answer for this particular question is B, remember B. So very important, very simple, 16th question. Then finally 17th, 18th and 19th, three questions, fine. Iodoform reaction, once again, third time I am telling this, I tell you, third time this iodoform reaction is answered by all except, right? See, CH3CHOH group is there, correct? So this can show. CH3CHO group is there, this can show. CH3CH2OH group is there, this can show. But propanol cannot show. Already we come across this type of question, you can refer that. Propanol cannot show, so the answer is D. Right, now. Actually, once again, this is also iodoform reaction only. I will tell you. See. This is not iodoform reaction. CH4COOH, which reacts with NH3 and on heating. What you are going to get? On heating. CH4COOH, NH3. C6H5COONH4 you will get. On heating you are going to get P as C6H5COONH2. Correct? Now, this react with NaBr. Remember, NaOH plus KBr. What is the reaction? Can you remember? This reaction is HBDr. HBDr andre no? Hoffman bromomide degradation reaction. Amayans chapter will discuss Marthi Hoda. Hoffman bromomide degradation reaction. So CO is removed. Hence you are going to get Q as C6H5NH2. NH2 is what? That is aniline. Aniline you got. Now you see. This aniline. This aniline is ortho and para director, correct? So this when it reacts with concentrated sulfuric acid, S2SO4. So in this case, SO3 is the electrophile. So electrophilic reaction take place. So you are going to get the answer as sulfonylic acid. So right, NH2 ortho position is hindered. Remember, spherical hindered. So you are going to get NH2 and SO3H. SO3H. What is the name of this? The name of this is sulfanilic acid. Remember, sulfanilic acid. So hence the answer for this question is C. 18th question. C is the answer. The last question, which is 19th question. See, 4 reactant and 4 product, 4 reactions are given. Match the reactant in the reaction. Now, acetic acid, Stefan's reaction, sodium phenate, methyl cyanate, toluene. Very simple, very easy. Correct? First, you can see, famous is HVZ. Nodi takshan helabodu. HVZ reaction undergone by only acids. Remember that too, alpha hydrogen should be there in the acid. So, acetic acid should be the answer. Correct? A1C. 1C. In which case, two options left. Fine. Second one, you will see, sodium phenate. Sodium phenate undergo. See, Cobb's reaction. In alcohol phenol chapter, I told. Cobb's reaction, sodium phenate, correct? So, because sodium phenate, A and D is left. Sodium phenate will never undergo Stefan's reaction. We know that. Stefan's reaction by cyanide. Right? So, sodium phenate should be D and toluene should be Friedel-Crafts reaction. Toluene should be Friedel-Crafts reaction. And the answer for this question is D. Remember, D. So, answer is D. So, this is about the final punch, KC 2020, aldehyde, ketones and carboxylic acid chapter. So, in the next video, I will come up with another different chapter. So, till then, thank you. Have a nice day.